So, dear students, welcome to our next video lecture. In this video, we are going to discuss interplanar spacing. So, what is meant by interplanar spacing? It is the spacing between two adjacent planes. It is the spacing between two adjacent planes. For example, suppose this this is one plane and this is another plane. So these are the two planes parallel to each other, and then whatever is the spacing between the two planes, that will be called as a interplanar spacing. So more correctly, we can say interplanar spacing is the perpendicular distance between the two planes parallel to each other, isn't it? So we have to calculate the expression for interplanar spacing of set of parallel planes in a lattice, or we can say in a crystal structure, isn't it? So to calculate the interplanar spacing, what we have done here is that we have considered, first of all, xyz, that is Cartesian coordinate system consisting of x, y, and z axis. So this is x axis, this is y axis, this is z axis. Similarly, suppose this origin O lies at a lattice point in a plane having indices HKL. Lattice origin O lies in a plane. Suppose this is the plane and this will be the origin. This is plane HKL with origin lying at the lattice point consisted by the plane. O is the origin and plane HKL. Now what we do, we consider another plane parallel to the previous one. Another plane parallel to the previous one, and let that plane is ABC. ABC, first plane is at the origin. You can imagine, suppose this is the coordinate system and the plane is at the back side consisting of origin and that of the lattice point also. Now consider another plane parallel to the previous plane. So obviously, since the two planes are parallel to each other, the indices will be the HKL. It will be having same indices. Now let this plane that we have considered intersect on at x axis by A by H. A by H will be the intercept of the plane along x axis. Similarly, intercept along the y axis will be B by K, because here this is come from the knowledge of Miller indices, because Miller indices are calculated by calculating the intercepts and their reciprocals. So if we go reverse, then intercept of the plane having Miller indices HKL will be equal to the intercept along x-axis will be A by H, intercept along y-axis will be B by K, and that of on z-axis will be C by L. So these will be the intercepts. Now the thing that we are interested in, that is interplanar spacing. So here, to calculate the interplanar spacing, what we do, we draw a normal from the origin O. So here, if we look here, look to the figure, I will just magnify the figure. You can see here, I will magnify the figure. So this is origin, this is origin, this is origin, So from the origin, you draw a normal n. So obviously this normal n will intersect the plane ABC at point P. So P is the point of intersection of the normal from the origin to the plane. So obviously the distance between O and P will be the interplanar spacing, because first plane is lying at O, another plane is lying at P, and these are parallel to each other. So D will be the interplanar spacing. Now another thing we can have is that, now if we join these points, for example, suppose ABC, if we join, the figure is, so if we join now here AP, if we join AP, then we will have a right angle triangle. APO will be the right angle triangle. Similarly, if we join C and P, so CPO will be another right angle triangle. And similarly, this BPO will also be the right angle triangle, isn't it? This will be the 90 degree angle. This will be the 90 degree angle. BPO is the right angle triangle. Now, in that, the angles made by the coordinate axis with the normal are taken as alpha, beta, and gamma. Alpha, beta, gamma are the angles made by coordinate axis with the normal, isn't it? So with all these inputs, now we will try to derive the expression for interplanar spacing. So first of all, now this B, since this BPO is the right angle triangle, we can have cos theta, or we can have cos of the angle alpha, cos of alpha will be equal to, now this angle AOP, yajamadhe ha alpha ahe, ha 90 degree ahe. So cos alpha will be given as adjacent side divided by diagonal. So adjacent side is, cos alpha will be, adjacent side is D, and that diagonal will be A by H. So from this we can write D is equal to A by H cos alpha. This is for this triangle AOP. Similarly, we can calculate D in terms of other angles or other intercepts, and that will be equal to B by HKL. So B by K cos alpha, and that will also be equal to C by L cos alpha, isn't it? So, sorry, not cos alpha, here it will be beta, cos beta, because angles are different. So here it will be beta, and here it will be gamma. So D will be given in terms of alpha, beta, gamma angles, in terms of intercepts, A by H cos alpha is equal to B by K cos beta, and that is equal to C by L cos gamma. So this we have got this equation, and let us call this as equation one. So now I will minimize that. So this is actually first equation that we have obtained. Now, where this alpha, beta, and gamma represent here the angles between the normals and the axis A, B, C respectively, that I have told you. Now, these cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are called as directional cosines. Cos alpha, cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are directional cosines. Of the normal to the plane HKL. Now, from equation 1, it is seen that the direction cosines are proportional to. Now, if we see here, if we see this equation 1, what we can see, we can write, if we write the equation for cos alpha, then we can write here cos alpha is equal to H by A into D. So here this H is constant, A is constant, D is constant. So we can say directional cosines are proportional to H by A. Sorry, this D is constant. So it will be proportional to H by A. So directional cosines are proportional to H by A. Cos alpha is proportional to H by A. Similarly, cos beta will be proportional to K by B and cos gamma is proportional to HKL L upon C. So now if n is the unit vector normal, what is n? This here, this I have drawn the normal. So if n cap is the normal unit vector normal, then A cos alpha, B cos alpha, A cos alpha, B cos beta, and C cos gamma may be written as. Now you see here, if n cap is the unit vector along the normal, then what will happen? A cos alpha can be written as n dot A upon H, n dot A, n dot A n dot B, and C cos gamma will be written as n dot C. How? N dot A, if we look for dot product of two vectors, n dot A is equal to, how it is given by? It is given as magnitude of n vector unit vector into A into cos alpha. So here we can see as n cap is the unit vector, its magnitude will be unity. So simply we will be having n dot A as n cos alpha. Similarly, we can go for other cells, so n dot B and n dot C. So with this, now putting these values, n dot A, n dot B, n dot C, we can replace now A cos alpha, B cos beta, and C cos gamma in equation 1. Equation 1 madhe A cos alpha hai, B cos beta hai, C cos of gamma hai. So we can replace this with N dot A like that. So what will happen? We will have D is equal to N cap A vector A divided by H is equal to N cap vector B dot N dot B divided by K. And this is equal to unit vector n dot vector c upon l. So this will be the new equation that we have obtained. Let this equation is 2. Now, so here value of d can be determined only if we are knowing the value of the unit vector. Just a minute. So we have written D is equal to dot product of n dot a upon h is equal to n dot b upon k is equal to n dot c upon l. Now this d can be determined if we know the unit vector n. So to determine the unit vector, what we do now, we will write down the equation of the plane HKL, which is making intercepts along x, y, z axis. So the equation of the plane under consideration is given by f of x, y, z, because it is the function of x, y, z coordinates. So f of x, y, z is equal to h upon a into x plus k upon b into y plus l into z upon c, and this is equal to 1. So this is actually equation of plane. This is equation of plane. Now for a surface f of x, y, z is equal to constant. If this surface is constant, then we can say, we can assume delta f as vector normal to it. Delta f as vector normal to it, and the vector n cap will be given by n cap is equal to n dot a upon sorry n delta f upon delta f. So this we can write as h upon a into unit vector I plus k upon b into unit vector j plus l upon c into unit vector k. Divided by, this is delta f is the vector normal. So normal vectors are, we can write down the vector as h upon a into I plus k upon b into j plus l upon c into k, and its modulus mod or its value. So it will be simply h square by a square plus k square by b square plus l square by c square. So from equation 2 now you see this is equation 2. So equation 2 says n dot a upon h is equal to d. So here n dot a, so a upon h is d. So h upon a will be 1 upon d. So now equation 2, we get equation 2. So let us consider first, d is equal to n dot a upon h. D is equal to n dot a upon h. Now this is equal to, now you put the value of this unit vector n cap as this. So we can write here, just a minute. I can copy this. So and n ची व्हॅल्यू ही आहे, हियर इट इज n इनटू डॉट a अपॉन h इनटू युनिट वेक्टर i, इजंट इट? सो नाउ दिस, नाउ वी हैव टू टेक डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ, नाउ दिस i डॉट i, I dot I will be 1, I dot j will be 0, I dot k will be also 0, because dot product of perpendicular vectors is 0. So on simplifying, we can write h upon a into a upon h divided by h square upon a square plus k square upon b square plus l square upon c square, and other things will be zero, plus I dot j, I dot k will be zero. So here this all will get cancelled, and we will have interplanar spacing d is equal to 1 upon h square upon a square plus k square upon b square plus l square upon c square. So in this way we have determined or we can write this as d is equal to 1 upon, now all these are squares, so we can just a minute, I went wrong here. This n cap happens to be like this, h square upon a square plus k square upon b square plus l square upon c square, bracket is to half. This is the standard formula for that n cap in terms of constant plane. So half, so this will again, it will be half here also. So here will be also half. So it will be half. So we are having interplanar spacing D as D is equal to 1 upon h square upon a square plus k square upon b square plus l square upon c square. So this is the formula for interplanar spacing of the plane HKL. A, B, C are the intercepts along x, y and z axis. Now if we are having cubic system, for cubic system, for cubic system we know that A is equal to B is equal to C, so we can replace this with any one vector. So let this is equal to A, so we will have D is equal to 1 upon h square upon a square plus k square upon a square plus l square upon a square raised to half. So this can be again simplified because now denominator is same, so it will be 1 upon h square plus k square plus l square upon a square. raised to 1/2. So this will be simply, now this a square will become a, and that will go to the numerator. So it will be b is equal to a upon under root h square plus k square plus l square. So this is the formula for interplanar spacing for cubic lattice. This is for cubic lattice, isn't it? So this gives the interplanar spacing. So with this we will stop here. In the next video, we are going to see some crystal structures. So by the time we will stop here.